All right, we are on the bottom section of page Kufchav Beis. to whatever degree we emphasize what we learned, we have to go further. We discussed it as everything over and over again. But the important thing, I think, we have to carry on. So we said, we're talking about ratzon now. Ratzon is quite different than sechel. And the principal difference is that sechel is a koyach pnimi, which means that sechel actually settles in into a keli. In which case it will relate to the keli in all its details, and the keli will accept the sechel in every aspect. They become, so to speak, one and together as one entity. The simple illustration of this is, even though this is on a different, completely different level, but nonetheless, there is that illustration. The goof comes to life when the neshama is in it, and we say the goof is alive. Sechel imbues itself in the kliya sechel, in the kelim, to the extent that the keli itself becomes sensitive to the sechel element. We discuss a little bit the sechel element. It is really a phenomenal thing. Sechel is mislabish in the keli. Ratzon, on the other hand, is a koyach, what's called koyach atzmi, not a haora. But simshu from the ratzon is the etzem haratzon, not the effect of the ratzon, but the phenomenon that he has a ratzon. This is ratzon, and therefore, and ratzon, from among other things, as a result of that, ratzon does not have a keli. There's such a thing as a keli for ratzon. The keli for ratzon is a living human being. In no way does that circumscribe ratzon or put some kind of a definitive quality to it. And then, towards the end of that top section, or the middle, the section before the 1B is starting, Rebbe said that to understand the principle that when ratzon is nimshach, expresses itself, it expresses itself, its very presence, it does not express any kind of consequence of what it wants. Its very presence, that's what it manifests. So the etzem ratzon is nimshach. Not like in sechel, a ha'ora. In sechel there is a ha'ora. Ha'ora means the message, the significance of what the sechel talks about. Now we go to the bottom section of page Kuf Chav Beis. V'lochein, for this reason, refers to the fact that the ratzon, when it's nimshach, it is the very essence of the ratzon, not its ha'ora. Therefore, oifun piulas ha'ratzon, the manner that the ratzon affects, shepeya b'chol ha'yivorim b'ha'koichos, that which the ratzon has an effect on all the yivorim and all the koichos. That, again, we discussed it, that's clear, that a person's functioning at any level, whether it is moving the foot or it is performing or learning sechel, it is all brought out and directed and demanded by ratzon. Ratzon is playing on a kechas on a yivorim. this piyula that Ratzon has on all the kochot on the Yevonim, who b'derech shlita or mamshal, the method, the manner in which the Ratzon expresses itself in all the kochot and all the Yevonim, it is not by, as we said the other day, in consultation. Are you ready to accept me? When you understand, but if I say such and such, the Ratzon comes in and takes over the entire management of this koyach and of this eiver. It is with derech shlita u'mamshala. It is in the manner of shlita. Shlita means rulership. Perhaps I should try to identify the difference between shlita and mamshala, and that will bring it even more to the forefront. Mamshala is like a government. A government sets rules. A government does not, by the virtue of a government, does not involve itself on a practical level in every detail of what's going on. It sets a rule and everyone has to follow this rule. That's what Memshola. Then there is a shlita element of the government. The government sets up police officers all over the place, watching how do you obey the rules of the government. It is also in a top-down type of a manner. The policeman, the function of the police is to enforce what the Mishola issued. It is not by cooperation with the citizen. It is by enforcing it in the
government. To remain on this call, press 1.
The Ratzon affects all the koches and all the involved. But there are shlita or memshala. In this manner, number one, it says memshala. It is the ruler. It is the top governor, so to speak. And then it also controls and rules every step of the way. In contrast, this is not like the effect that sechel has. This is the phenomenon which we discussed already a few times, that the sechel also has an effect on all the koiches. This is an important thing to contemplate and to recognize. There is not an action that a person can does without the sechel participating and giving guidance as to how, and not only how, but what should be done. This is what sechel is. Sechel is not only what's called book learning. Sechel is that which follows the person or guides the person around every second of the day. Even as a person sleeps, there's a right way to lie in bed and the wrong way to lie in bed. A way that the sechel recognizes, oh, that's the way a human being should be lying. And a wrong way. There's a constant effect of the sechel. And it's spoiled by kol ha-koiches. Just like Ratzon, sechel also is spoiled by kol ha-koiches in all the koiches. It, so to speak, it negotiates with all the koiches. But in sechel, in this distinct for us, this in that the sechel affects all the koiches is not in a manner of shlita, of rulership, of directing it, so to speak, from top down. It is rather in getting involved and negotiating with the koich and with the eber. And then it goes into details and explains it. Okay, as for example, Masha Moyach Shalat al Halev, the principle that the Moyach rules the heart, over the heart. An extremely important principle. The heart may have all kinds of different reactions to different circumstances. Reactions or altogether of different interests. The Moyach gives has a different perspective. Moyach speaks in terms of right and wrong, not in terms of the lev, like and don't like. And who is in charge? Moyach Shalat al Halev. The Moyach rules the heart. The Moyach controls the heart. It tells the heart, and it makes the heart follow its directive. And this in that Moyach is Shalat al Halev. Shein zeh bederech memshola. This rule that the lev, that the heart Moyach has over the heart. A is not bederech memshola. It's not in a memshola manner. It is not that the melech stands aloof and says, "I don't care what you have interest in. I don't care what entices you," and so forth. Here is the rule. This is not how the melech, that the moyach relates to the heart. The moyach gives credence to the heart. And it relates to the heart and to its interests. And there it comes out and it has it gives guidance and effects. And that effect is not b'derech memshol. It is not by a standoffish directive. Kiyim, rather bebchinas oir pnimi. In the bechina of oipnim, of an internalized oir, the moyach illuminates the heart and actually shows it and gives the heart an appreciation of its contribution.
It's like it has a conversation.
It imbues itself into the heart and gives the heart an appreciation, a moyach perspective. Shepoyo behamidos. That the Moyach Shalat al Halev, that Shepoyel al Hamidos, that the Moyach affects, has an effect on the Midos, even though the Midos on their own will have their own unbridled interests running all over the place. And the Moyach is Shalat al Halev, and it has an effect on the Midos. What is the effect that it has on the Midos? Not by top-down control. That the midas should be, that things in a person's heart should be according to the guidance of the sechel. There is a perfect cooperation there. Ukmeshin is boiling here, be pilikanah. as we already discussed much earlier. Vehu gamkein, this inyan that the Mayach directs, is shalit, rules over the heart, in a sense. Shalit means he is ultimately the winner. And how does that take place? Yes, indeed, the midos get to appreciate what the Moyach is illuminating them with, is telling them. It's a pnimizdike relationship. Vehu gamkein, and that too is inyan ulfuno v'limut. This is the principle of ulfuno v'limut. Ulfuno means learning and teaching. Sha sechel melamed umanigas amidus. But the sechel teaches, and then furthermore continues to guide the midas. There is a continuous interrelationship, interaction, inter-negotiation as to the right way and the wrong way. The right and the wrong altogether. And when the Moichin identify in the midas an ugly midas, a midas that is not really compensated with the principles of the Moichin, it negotiates with the midah, and it has to explain to you how ugly this attitude is, and thereby getting the midah back in the fold, and the midah comes back to the Moichin and accepts the guidance and the illumination of the Moichin. This is Moich Shalit Alalei. Even though it's called shalit, shalit means having the power of a ruler, but it's not, he said only shalit, not memshol. Memshol, as we said before, memshol means just an issue of edict, of a directive, of a law. The mayor does not relate to midas in this, to the heart in this manner. Shalit means he goes down, so to speak, to the fray, to the place where the challenge is, and he go and directs the midas and illuminates the midas. Don't you see? This is not the right way to do it. Here's the right way to do it, and the midah ultimately appreciates that. Yes, indeed, this is the right way to do it. And the midah also appreciates ultimately that to do it the right way is the right way for itself too. This is the effect of the Meichin upon the Midas. And it's a real effect, it's a pnimizike effect. To the extent that it's an appropriate expression, it has beautiful Midas. Beautiful Midas means that the Midas are in themselves beautiful. They're not just acting beautifully, but they themselves are beautiful. Normally, midos are interested, so to speak, in they're selfish. But the effect of the sechel on the midos, when the midah actually begins to appreciate the importance and significance of recognizing the good that it can do. That this is all phenomenally, and that applies even to midos, which are really standalone koiches. They have their own interests. And the Moichin will shalit alav. Moich can influence the heart. Huh. But it's an influence, not a rulership. So that after the influence is taking hold, the midah remains in place. But it's now influenced by the Moichin. Now, in the middle of the third line from the bottom. The reason I'm this is again a new bridge to cross. V'yesh gamkein, however, there is also this inyan shehamoichin poyalim bitul behamikus. There is another phenomenon. There is also an additional inyan that the moichin will negotiate with the midah and he'll elevate and refine the midah. There is also the inyan that the moichin poyalim bitul behamikus. The moichin affect a beetle in the midas. What is beetle mean? Normally midas are personal experiences. The midah of ahava, the midah of yira. Even though ahava per se is a decent human meaning. Then there is also Yira's Amelch, for example. It's appropriate to recognize the status of the Melch and have Yira for the Melch. When it says, Yishi ima bi obitiro, Yira from one's parents. These are all fine qualities and meters. But along with it being fine meters, there's an element of beetle that Moichin brings to the meters. What is the element of beetle? Beetle means it's a phenomenal thing that the media recognizes that there is something greater and higher than itself. Normally, media is internal, involved in its own appreciation, its own experience. But there is an element of beetle. But the media itself submits to that which is higher and greater and truer than itself. This is a phenomenon in midas. Moichin, this is a natural thing. But for midas, this is totally not natural. And then the Rebbe says, there is also this union that the moichin pale and beetle in the midas. The effect of beetle in the midas. So that the midah, excuse me, gets to appreciate, to be submissive. Can you tell this guy to get off me?
Kind of clean up the place.
Clean up the place, right. When we say the making poem beat the midahs, it is not merely that one, I better correct this, otherwise I'm going to get into trouble. Pay on beat of Hamidus means they actually refine the meter, that the meter has an internal sense of beat. This is a tremendously profound effect. While being a personal experience, it has union from beetle in the middle. Between this personal experience is union of being submissive, of being recognizing something greater than oneself, and giving credence, giving a state of precedent and value on the midas level. This is a tremendous effect. This is the effect of that making. Even making heaven affect the midas, even at that level. And the Rebbe explains, how is it that the making can be effective to the extent of the poil of beetle in the midas. This is the exact opposite of midas are. Midas are principally my personal experience. What I like, what I don't like. He may be making a poil a beetle in the midas. A submissive quality in the midas. The Rebbe explains how is it possible? And how is this come through? How is this beetle come from the Meichon to the Midas? The explanation is as follows. Because being that the Meichon be'etzem, the Meichon in essence, By Moichin, the union from beetle is not of a secondary status. It's necessary to be submissive in order to get to the truth of this. Moichin be'etzem is the union from beetle. Be'etzem, the union from Moichin is to know the truth as it is unto itself, not as it lends itself to my understanding. This is where Moichin, so to speak, come to life. To be submissive to the sechel and to get to the truth of it. The Be'etzim Moichin is beetle. I want to call your attention, as we do from time to time, in the form of the presentation, in the words that the Rebbe presents. We have had this experience for quite a few times, so now it will be possible to express the following. The Rebbe says, I'm reading from the second line from the bottom. Shehamoichin be'etzem heim bechinas bit. The moichin be'essence are the bechina bit. You would think that here the expression should be bivchinas beetle, in a beetle state, moichin am moichin, and they have a beetle element. The Rebbe says no. The Rebbe puts it straight out. The moichin be'etzem heim bechinas beetle. They are the union from beetle. This was moichin is. Moichin is the union from beetle. Because the union from moichin is to know that which is completely outside, beyond my reality. Moichin is to know the creator rather than the created. This is Moichin. He begins beetle. The other begins of beetle. Therefore, being that Moichin are be'etzem bechinas beetle, the element, the aspect of beetle, hareihem poyalim beetle behind midas gamki. Thus, the Moichin affect the beetle in the midas, also. That midas also get infected, so to speak, with this quality of beetle. Because Moich shalet al alev, so the close proximity between the midas and the Moichin at that stage affect the midas with the essential inim of Moichin. So this is the essential meaning of Moichin. The essential meaning of Moichin is not what it says, what it discovered, but how did it discover it? Again, if you be sensitive to the lotion, please recognize. We would think it should say bivchinas beetle, between distinguish between the Moichin himself and the beetle element. It says no, heim bivchinas beetle. This is the essential aspect of Moichin. This is what makes Moichin Moichin. They don't stand on the principle. No, I need to have a personal understanding, a personal knowledge. Hein bechinas bitl. This is the inner bitl. What there is to know, that's what I know. Therefore, harehem poyerim bitl b'amidas gamki. Therefore, by their proximity and interrelationship that moich shalat alana, they therefore affect in the midas also the inner bitl. Because if the moichin are there, this is what moichin is bitl. V'hoyikor, principally, the union, the effect of bitl that moichin have upon the midas as a result of their interrelationship, hu mibchinas ha-chochmo. It is from the beginning of the chochmo in the moichin. As it explained elsewhere. Let me pay attention to this for a moment. I have a couple of minutes. Although the negotiation process of Moichin and Midas is not on the level of Chochmah or the level of Bina. But the Moichin explains, this is the way this should be done, this is the way, this is the right way. Based on my perspective that I get from Chochmah, this is the right way. However, as we explained many times, it's an extremely important principle. And this is in from Moichin, that despite the fact that it goes down into Bina, and it gets to be fully understood with all its ramifications and details and how it's correct and how it fits into the situation. The element of Chochmah is the principle that illuminates and gives it credence, substantiates its truth. The Chochmah must always be brought along and recognized and seen. From no matter where the making is involved, there has to be the perspective, okay, what is it all about? Where does it all come from? What's the principle behind it? This which I know is at Chochmah. I've been saying it's Chochmah, we know because it's there. That's like sight. Not because I'm convinced and I'm proven, but the way I see it. And the Yikir HaBitl is from the beginnings of Chochmah, the beginning of Chochmah of the Meichin. So, when Meichin come to Midas, and they poil, and they and Meichin Shalder Aleph, which is at the level of Pino, directing Midas, explaining what is right and what is wrong. Meichin come to Midas, even though in Pino, they come along with the Chochmah that's behind it. Along with the principle that this is what the truth is. The truth is a divine truth. Not even a worldly truth. It's not based on advantages or on a worldly value. Principle, survival. It's based on what the truth is, of the divine truth. That's Chochmah. This Chochmah element follows with the Meirin at all levels into Bina and into Das. The Chochmah is always embracing, always illuminating the Meirin. And because of the principle of the presence of Chochmah at all levels of Meirin, therefore, even at the point where it negotiates with the Midas, the Chochmah is also sensed, and Chochmah is beetle. Therefore, that beetle is effective on the Midas also.